This is a demonstration of the GPT prototype for CAP. Let us imagine we're in the following situation. Our business has experienced significant growth lately and we are receiving many new customer inquiries. The product owner asked me to build an app so we can handle all the inquiries and not risk customer dissatisfaction. She gave me a lengthy description of how the app needs to be. I must develop a business app for a ticketing system that enables customers to submit tickets and agents to handle and resolve them efficiently. The server should be capable of both receiving ticket submissions from various channels such as email, phone or web portal and storing the necessary customer information and ticket details in the database. It should also include functionalities for assigning tickets to agents based on availability, expertise and workload. The goal is to supply a robust and reliable server-side solution for effective ticket management, enhancing customer satisfaction and streamlining internal processes for the business. We start in an empty directory and use the GPT prototype for CAP to generate a new app from scratch. We simply provide a prompt to describe our business use case, and that's it. This is the exact same requirement we just got from the product owner describing the ticketing system. It then generates the respective CDS model definitions and services. These are files which you would usually have to code manually to build a CAP app. To properly test the app, we need realistic test data, which would usually be a lengthy and tedious process. But here it is generated in seconds. Large language models are incredibly useful for generating code based on textual descriptions. Errors may occasionally occur during the generation, but proper checks and retry mechanisms are in place to ensure that the experience is as seamless as possible. Let's wait until the test data generation is completed. Now we can have a look at our generated model definitions and we see customer, agent, and ticket. Let's look at the service. All three entities are exposed in our ticketing service. Let's start the app with our command CDS watch. With generated UI annotations, we get a functioning Fury Elements app. You can see 5 tickets based on our sample data. Let's search for website. Let's select the entry and modify the issue. We modify the priority to 2.5. Since it's a number without any decimals allowed, we get an appropriate error message. So let's change it to 3 and save the issue. In order to be able to track the process better, the product owner needs information about the communication between agent and client. She gave me a text describing the process. Let us modify the app for the updated requirements. We just provide a suitable prompt to describe how we want to change the app. It then regenerates the data model to take the desired changes into account. In this case, we want to store the communication between the agents and customers so all relevant information is available. Once the model is regenerated, the existing data is adjusted accordingly. Let us look at the updated model. We see that there is a new entity, communication, which has a message and an association to ticket, and each ticket has many communications. Let us run CDS Watch again to preview the modified app. Let's search for network. We can see a new section, communications, with 2 messages, one from Michael Williams, initial message, and one from Jim Brown, response from agent. Simply put, building and modifying a CAP server using only textual descriptions has simplified app development and has made it more accessible than ever. It will save development time and cost for your business.